Hello friends, it's Kick here, and in today's episode we have a lineup waiting for you, including Bill Gates' startup which has begun construction of its first nuclear reactor. Elon Musk announced that 1,000 Optimus robots will be working at the Tesla factory already next year. Data for training neural networks, which as it turns out, are already running out. A robot driver, which has been tested on the roads of Japan. The Electra electric aircraft that does not require a runway in the crater of a Martian volcano where a lake of frozen water was found. All this and much more right now, let's go! Today we will start with Bill Gates' startup, which began the construction of its first nuclear reactor. According to Bill Gates, founder and chairman of the board of the so-called TerraPower, the Natrium station will be the most advanced in the world, it will be much safer than modern reactors, and it will produce far less waste. The next generation nuclear power plant is being built in a state known as Coal, near the shutting down coal-fired Norton Power Station. TerraPower plans to use some of the equipment and will also hire about 100 former coal miners. While the first phase of construction work is underway, the USA Nuclear Regulatory Commission will assess the future reactor. If permission is granted, construction of the energy island with steam turbines and other equipment will begin in 2025. The commissioning of Natrium is planned for around 2030. The declared power of the fast neutron reactor with a sodium coolant is 345 megawatt. An energy storage uses a molten salt battery. Peak power of 500 megawatt should be enough to supply electricity to 400,000 homes. The presence of a battery allows integrating Natrium into a power grid with a source of renewable energy. This is the only such project in the world. By the way, in addition to Bill Gates, the co-owners of TerraPower include the Department of Energy and the energy company Pacific Corp. Elon Musk announced that Tesla plans to use more than 1,000 Optimus robots at its factories next year. According to him, this will lead to a significant increase in the value of the company. Musk emphasized that the market for humanoid robots is about 1 billion units per year, and Tesla aims to capture at least 10% of this market. According to him, Tesla plans to produce robots at a cost of about $10,000 each and sell them for $20,000. The company recently announced that two Optimus robots are already working autonomously at one of its plants. Musk added that next year Tesla intends to deploy from 1,000 to several thousand robots at its facilities, although customer shipments are not yet planned. Elon is confident that by 2026, Optimus will become a fully programmable robot capable of performing a variety of tasks. However, skeptics note that such ambitious statements from Musk regarding other products of his company have not always corresponded to reality. Optimus, also known as Tesla Bot, is a humanoid robot designed to perform various tasks. It is 173 centimeters tall and weighs 73 kilograms, capable of carrying loads up to 20 kilograms and lifting up to 68 kilogram. The robot is equipped with a 2.3 kilowatt per hour battery, providing a full workday's charge, and uses about 100 watts in a resting state and up to 500 watts when walking. Optimus has 28 structural actuators, allowing its body to move with a high degree of freedom, and its hands are agile enough for various manipulations. Optimus can walk, squat, balance on one leg, lift, and move objects. The robot is controlled by AI similar to that used in Tesla cars. It relies on visual navigation and can learn from real tasks by repeating human actions. The robot can connect to Wi-Fi and LTE, allowing its software to be easily updated remotely. Meanwhile, as many experts now report, companies developing artificial intelligence are running out of training textual data for the subsequent development of language models. The qualitative leap of the latest versions of artificial intelligence from companies such as OpenAI, Google, and others is associated with the fact that language models were trained on huge arrays of textual data. However, knowledge bases created over many decades by humans are running out. Billions of words, billions of web pages are virtually exhausted, making further AI development nearly impossible. The point is that companies developing AI are unable to use absolutely all the information, including from web archives, because authors can sue them, as happened with publishers of the New York Times. They sued OpenAI for copyright infringement. For this reason, researchers from the analytical center Epoch AI believe that already by 2026, ChatGPT and Llama 3 will simply have nothing to feed them. Specialists believe that further training of language models is possible already due to the material generated by them. However, OpenAI and Google are already practicing this strategy. The downside of this approach is that the quality of training through content created by AI will decrease. In the end, a self-deception funnel may occur, and language models will provide answers based on previously false data created by AI. Let's move on. Employees of the Japanese laboratory Juhu System Kugaku shared interesting footage of an electric taxi where a humanoid robot acted as the driver. The android was named Musashi, and its demonstration is intended to show the potential of autonomous technologies in the country. Musashi was first introduced in 2019 as a test development to check various control systems. He has human-like proportions, including a musculoskeletal system. At System Kugaku, the robot was trained in driving skills. The humanoid is equipped with high-resolution cameras, one in each eye. Both can rotate and tilt for a wider view. The robot got behind the wheel of a car, Choto Odekake Machima de Suisui, released by Toyota in 2012. The car was equipped with Wi-Fi and an Intel NUC computer. Musashi still has much to learn from real people, such as confidently driving on slopes and turns. For now, the robot requires too much time to perform ordinary actions. In the future, Johu System Kugaku wants not only to endow the robot with driving functions, but also to teach it to help people, for example, to go shopping and carry items. Meanwhile, the design developed by the company Electra allows aircraft to take off and land using small areas the size of a football field, 90 monomachs 30 meters. The loudness of Electra's motors does not exceed 75 decibels at a distance of 91 meters. 8 small propellers direct airflow over the wings, creating tremendous lift at low speeds. 5 of them operate on quiet electric motors powered by lithium batteries, allowing takeoff and landing to be fully electric. The cruising speed of Electra is 322 kilometers per hour. The range of the electric aircraft is 805 kilometers. Installing a hybrid system will reduce fuel consumption by 40% for every 161 kilometers. Electra has already made its first test flight at Manassas Airport in Virginia on the demonstration prototype EL-2 Goldfinch. Serial production of aircraft is planned to be organized by 2028. And since we've taken to the sky, let's look at another beauty from the heavens. China's leading aviation construction conglomerate AVIC conducted the first flight tests of an experimental cargo drone of the airplane type. The twin-engine cargo drone with a takeoff weight of 2 tons is capable of delivering 700 kilograms of payload over 520 kilometers at speeds up to 300 kilometers per hour. Developments are also underway for 5 and 10-ton drones, which will eventually change logistics in China and all interested countries. About 3 years ago, Chinese authorities began changing legislation with the goal of creating a low-altitude economy. According to the changing policy, for example, drones are to become a key tool for delivering goods over medium distances at altitudes below 3,000 meters. For example, the first cargo drone from the company DJI, Model Flycart 30, noted for its experimental delivery of goods to Everest. But DJI alone is not China's strength. More than 2,300 companies developing drones operate in the country, and the range of this product has overcome the threshold of 1,000 varieties. The Aviation Industrial Corporation of China, as one of the giants of Chinese aviation construction, strives to be at the forefront of the process. The conglomerate's capabilities and its connections with the National Aviation Regulator allow faster and easier organization of experimental technology tests, and therefore sooner bring developments to commercial maturity. Thus, the experimental cargo drone HH-100 was tested at a general-purpose aerodrome in operated airspace, which says a lot by itself. In the future, the conglomerate promises to launch 2 and 5 times heavier machines into the air. Express cargo delivery will never be the same again. By the way, these same drones are promised to be adapted for fighting forest fires. And what would cake be without space? In the crater of a Martian volcano, a lake of frozen water was found. The study showed that frost forms on cold Martian nights and quickly evaporates after sunrise. This thin layer of ice weighs at least 150,000 tons, which is equivalent to the water volume in 60 Olympic swimming pools. Frost was found with high-quality images taken by the orbital devices Trace Gas Orbiter and Mars Express. The discovery could significantly affect perceptions of Mars' climate systems and water behavior on the planet. It is possible that Mars previously had a different climate cycle, characterized by precipitation and snowfall at high altitudes. Scientists suggest that microclimatic conditions on the slopes of volcanoes promote the formation of frost, especially in shady calderas, basins formed by eruptions or crater collapses. These phenomena are observed not only on Mars but also on Earth, where similar processes create seasonal clouds. And that's all for today. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to subscribe and hit the bell to stay updated on high-tech news. Peace to your home.